Elements help you create structure and add content to your pages in Webflow. In this video, we'll start with a blank canvas and add common elements from key categories in the Add panel to explore how elements can work together to create pages. And along the way, we'll check out a few of their settings. For now, we'll focus only on building. You can learn all about styling your elements in another lesson. Let's start with the structure category. First, we'll drag in a section. Sections help define distinct parts of a page, like a hero, feature area, or footer. Inside that, we'll add a container, which will keep our content centered and aligned across different screen sizes. Now, we have a few options for what to put inside our container to hold its content. One option would be to add a quick stack, which creates a flexible grid layout with just a few clicks. But for more precise control, to build the layout yourself, you might use div blocks, which are found in the basic elements category. A div block is a flexible element you can use to group other elements together. There are many spacing properties and layout options you can choose to get things arranged exactly how you want them. And eventually, you can style divs inside of divs or next to other divs. But for now, we'll keep it simple with just one. Inside the div block, we'll drag in a heading for our main page title from the typography category. And then just click in and edit it. We'll keep it an H1 for now, but we could change its level on the canvas or in the settings panel to establish hierarchy and help with accessibility and SEO. Below that, still inside the div, we'll add a paragraph to explain what the page is about. Before we go on, it's a good idea to check our navigator panel to make sure our elements are ordered and nested how we wanted them. With that sorted out, we'll add a button from the basic category. We can update the button text to something descriptive, like sign up now, or in our case, start your free lesson. Then in the element settings, we can choose where it links, such as an external URL, page, section, or email address. Next, let's add some visuals from the media section. We'll start with an image element. This is a placeholder, but you can replace it with a logo or product shot. And of course, you can reorder it, choose some settings, and style the image or its parent div. To embed a video, use a video or YouTube element and paste in your link when ready. With the YouTube element, you get many of YouTube's playback controls. Within media, you can also add Lottie animations, Rive animations, and spline 3D scenes to give your sites more dimensionality and intrigue. But we'll move on to forms, which help you collect information from your visitors. We'll start with a form block, which groups all the form parts together, and we'll drop it in a new div. By default, it includes a button and a couple of label and text field elements, but you can edit, remove, or add other elements to customize it. And there are form-specific settings. For example, you can toggle between normal, success, and error states, and edit elements or styles for those states. Or, back on the form element, choose redirect behavior after a visitor submits the form. In other words, where they'll go, if anywhere, after submitting. And here at the top, you can assign a unique ID to the form. This is useful for when you want to reference elements in code or link to them from another area on your page. Let's go on to advanced elements, which add more functionality to your site. For example, the navbar is a pre-built layout with space for your branding and links, a must-have for the top of most pages on your site. We can choose from all kinds of settings, like how menu options are revealed and on which breakpoints we start to see a menu icon instead of page links. Next, a bit lower down, we'll add a search element to help users find content quickly. Within the input element settings, we can customize placeholder text for the search bar. When you've got the hang of some things, you can also customize the full results page that's automatically created for you with the search element. And if you need something entirely custom, you can use the code embed element to paste in your own HTML, CSS, or JavaScript. Okay, with our homepage structure built, let's wrap up and talk about what's next. We covered a lot of elements, from structure to advanced. Along the way, we explored how element settings let you control behavior, links, IDs, and more. But there are still many more elements and settings to explore. If you're ever unsure how something works, hover over it and click the question mark for a quick demo and some tips. And if you want to get a head start on your next section, check out the starter library of layouts in the Add panel. These combine elements into pre-built sections like heroes or layouts to showcase your team or logos of your top clients and many more that you can plug right in and start styling. Or get even more custom by following the workflow to generate your next layout with the Webflow AI Assistant. Choose from options made to match your site. Decide if you want to make any edits. And watch the magic happen. Stepping back, we've got a solid homepage structure, and while it doesn't look very impressive yet, styling can take it from this to this. And once you get the hang of creating and styling elements, you can save them, or combinations of them, by creating components, which are reusable building blocks, and an essential part of your design system in Webflow. We'll cover that in another video, but for now, you've got a strong foundation to start building with elements in Webflow.